6, ladies and gentlemen, Rick Perry is going to get a bunch of people together in a big old sports arena, and they're all going to pray for the future of Texas. Why? Because Rick Perry says the problems that face America and Texas are too big to be solved by people. We have to turn it over to God. So as of August 6th, the state of Texas is no longer governed by its government. It's governed by God. What the fuck is The Onion gonna do? Like, what? How do you parody this? How do you even make fun of this? This is absurd in and of itself. Like, how, like, if I was a comedy writer and I wanted to satirize this, what could I possibly fucking do? What could be done to make this more ridiculous than it already is?
Texas and America are in a tough financial spot. Instead of addressing the problem, perhaps we should send the U.S. military to seek out the leprechauns and steal their precious, precious gold.
In order to solve the problems of Texas, I'm going to sticky tape stuffed toys to my wall. Spend the day in my pajamas. Refuse to swallow or blink. Collect and catalogue roadkill, and masturbate furiously and incessantly. These are all fine ideas, and I think equally as effective as prayer.
Prayer is not effective!
Texas is lacking leadership in the here and now, but I've thought of a solution just as effective as a state prayer meeting. Perhaps we should perform a seance and ask the ghost of Sam Houston for advice. Only his wisdom, and not our present governor, can solve our current woes.
Governor Rick Perry of Texas is calling upon all Americans to pray and fast on August 6th, to come together and beg for God's forgiveness for having been born, basically. That man is out of his mind on so many levels. Asking Americans to fast? Good luck with that one, guy. I mean, who elected this meatball? He wants to solve real problems, such as a war that is draining us dry, a recession, and an unemployment rate that continues to inch towards economic collapse by organizing a big talk-to-the-sky fest. Poverty, terrorism, he's going to solve with prayer. Look, I'm actually going to do something productive and be a part of a real solution. I invested every last dollar to my name, and I traded it all for these magic beans.
Perhaps the state legislature should call Madam Zarazuza's psychic hotline and ask her for advice on our state's finances. Should we buy lottery tickets or look between the couch cushions?
So apparently the problems of Texas and America are too big for man to solve. So I suggest we broadcast our problems into space on the off chance there's intelligent life in the galaxy. If there is, we should get a response within 8 to 200,000 years. And if not, at least Rick Perry will be done his presidency by then.
I embrace wholeheartedly Governor Perry's call for a day of prayer. And on the given day, I hope that everybody in his auditorium and all of you on YouTube will join me in singing a song that will call to the Lord's mind an organization that has enjoyed unparalleled success. Yes, we are going to sing the famous Sirius Cybernetics Corporation theme song.
Share and enjoy, journey through life with a plastic boy or girl by your side. Let your pal be your guide, and when it breaks down or starts to annoy, or cries when it moves and you of joy, cause it seems that you had more sex with your cat. Rip pile of your wall, or rent off your door, and you get to the point you can't stand anymore. Bring it to us, we won't give a pig. We'll tell you, come stick your head in the pig.
A bunch of fucking morons whispering into their hands for a solution to a problem. You know, here's an idea. Get to fucking work. Do something. You know, this does not do anything. This does something. Fucking get out there. Make something happen with actual effort.
How are we going to solve all of the world's problems?
Duct tape.
I'm going to solve them by using the Force. These are not the idiotic behaviors you're looking for.
I'm going to fix the hole in my roof by making my cat wear a funny hat.
What can we possibly do about global warming, terrorism, and the budget crisis?
I'm going to fap every 4 hours and 25 minutes, only using circular motions, while watching George Carlin's You Are All Diseased.
I will be unnecessarily loud. Always.
We'll solve it with air guitar. That'll fix everything.
I'm going to help stabilize the economy by doing something unspeakable with this large hunting knife.
I know something that will help with all of Texas's problems. It'll turn us all around. Literally. It's the hokey pokey. Here's how you do it. Put your right foot in. Take your right foot out. Put your right foot in, and bear with me, you shake it all about. You do the hokey pokey, and no one's really quite clear on what that is, so I'm just going to do this. Then, you turn yourself about. Now that's what it's all about.
Texas is experiencing a terrible drought. Instead of prayer, why don't we all agree to wash our cars on the same day? It can be Texas Wash Your Car Day. It's sure to come a gully washer after that.
I'm going to cure all the world of hemorrhoids by sitting in my closet and count my toes.
We have reached the point where we cannot be parodied. We cannot be satirized at this point. We are so ridiculous that we are just living in the world of the Onion. They can just become a straight news organization now. That's what's happened, folks.
Perhaps we should align our cosmic energies using 30-foot-high crystals.
See, I've got this big old blue ox called Babe, and I will hitch Babe to the economy. Yes, I will hitch Babe to the struggling American economy, and I will say, pull, Babe, pull, and all of you will yell and cheer, pull, Babe, pull, and Babe will brace his back hooves against the Rockies, his front hooves against the Catskills, and he will chug with all his might. And when the economy is stretched all nice and taut, I will take my axe and chop off the busted end of the economy. Now, trust me, Babe can beat out a stadium full of praying Texans any day of the week.
Welcome to fucking retardtopia.
Perhaps we should harness the true firepower of this fully armed and operational battle station to destroy our national debt.
In order to help America, I will be taking a pencil, such as this, inserting it into an old pencil sharpener, like this. I'm going to grind it all the way down, collect all the shavings, which I'm then going to put into a bowl, like this, and set fire to them whilst reading the works of William McGonagall. God bless America.
Welcome to Planet Stupid.
Perhaps we should find the Boggy Creek Monster, Texas Bigfoot, and see if he wants to run for governor.
I just want my kitty cat to love me.
Do you really want to fix the Texan economy? Do you really want to fix the Texan government's problems? Three words. Cat. Drum circle.
Stars at night are big and bright, deep in the heart of Texas.
Perhaps we should finally resolve to locate the lost city of Atlantis. and see if we can drill for oil there.
I just want my teddy bear to love me.
Perhaps we should offer bounties on the reptilian aliens that we all know are really running our government into the ground.
Why is this happening now?
Because it's the same kind of thing that happens to everybody and has happened to everybody since time immemorial. These are common occurrences, not a big deal. And besides, what are you complaining about? Things are a lot better now than they were 100 years ago.
But why is this happening to us?
Because you voted Rick Perry and other politicians like him into office, damn it! Stop watching Fox News!
This is Texas fictitious Governor Prick Error. Any resemblance to a real Prick Error is just one of life's little parodies. Years ago, my financial advisors warned me that if we restructured the state's taxes the way I wanted, we would face a $25 billion budget deficit in just 4 years. I responded by creating tax breaks for the major oil companies. Texas is the nation's biggest polluter, and I even sued the federal government to keep it that way. Our climate ain't changing until Jesus comes back real soon. But you know what? Our state's deficit is $27 billion. My advisors were billions of dollars off the mark, so why should I listen to them? Besides, we could make up for some of that just by firing several thousand school teachers and a few thousand prison employees. Now, I know we got a lot of prisons, and we keep them all pretty full, but to be fair, we do kill a lot of them boys, too. And of the hundreds of prisoners executed under my administration so far, I'm sure that at least some of them were probably guilty, including the one who was exonerated before we killed him anyway. I don't believe in moral relativism, and I don't believe in the abortion of an undeveloped fetus either, because that would be murder. And I don't believe in sex education. We teach abstinence only, which is why Texas has the highest rate of repeat teen pregnancies of any state in America. That may also be why a quarter of the children that live in Texas live below the poverty line. I responded to that by gutting child support services. I know also that Texas has the highest rate of uninsured residents of any state in the U.S. My response to that would be to drop programs like Social Security and Medicaid, if they'd let me do it. That's why I need to cultivate a special kind of unquestioning constituency, with vacant smiles on their obediently bobbing and gullibly believing heads. So I responded by consistently choosing only unqualified right-wing religious fundamentalists on the State Board of Education, specifically to undermine education in science, health, and social studies. Because of me, the economy is in trouble, and communities are in crisis. The problems I helped create are beyond my ability to fix. Don't you wish they would just magically fix themselves? Now that's a great idea. Let's forget all about my responsibility in all of this, because I want to be the next president, and I want to be as impotent in Washington as I was in Austin. So let's all get together on August 6th at Reliance Stadium in Houston, Texas, and let's all just wish that things would get better. Let's get thousands of people together and wish all at once, but not for the same thing, though. We don't want to concentrate our inaction because we don't want to admit when it obviously didn't work, like back in April when I asked everybody to pray for rain. So let's instead ask everybody to pray for different things, random things, personal things that matter only to you. That way, if something good happens for any of us, we can all pretend like we really did something. Don't wish for refreshments, though. With me in office, we can't afford that anymore. We're going to have to promote the virtues of fasting instead. So come on, Texas. I don't listen to my own advisors, and I won't be accountable either. As an elected leader, I'm incompetent to do my job. So all I'm going to say is, Jesus, take the wheel.
Jesus, take the wheel.
Jesus, take the wheel.